Hansel and Gretel. Long, long ago, the two children of a woodcutter, Hansel and Gretel, were lost in a forest. The children wandered around and found a strange house made of chocolates, candies, bread and cake in the middle of the forest. The hungry children grabbed a piece of house and started eating. Suddenly, an old witch appeared and caught the children. She locked Hansel in a cage and made Gretel do all the housework. One day, the witch told Gretel to heat the oven. When the oven was hot, Gretel asked the witch to check the temperature. Just as the witch bent over the oven, Gretel pushed her into the oven. Then she rescued Hansel out of the cage and hugged him. Before leaving, they took the witch's treasure and a basket full of food. Finally, the children found their way back to the house and their father. The Greedy Woodcutter. One day, a woodcutter named Peter found a cave full of treasure. He was staring at the gold when Norwin, the elf, entered the cave. Norwin asked, "What are you doing inside my cave?" Peter replied, "I found this cave. If you do not give me gold, I'll tell everybody about it." Norwin agreed to share the gold with Peter and gave him 2 bags of gold. But Peter was a greedy man. He reached the cave at night to steal the gold. Norwin had known that Peter was greedy and would come back. So, he put a spell and made gold look like coal. Peter was shocked to see coal in place of gold. His ears also started to grow and were soon bigger than his head. Peter was so scared that he promised never to steal again. Norwin removed the spell and Peter ran all the way to home. The Goblin and the Wizard. Once, a goblin and a wizard were arguing over who was better at magic. They saw a poor-looking man sitting under a tree and decided to ask him. They went up to him and asked, "Sir, which one of us is better at magic?" "Unless you show me, how can I tell you?" said the poor man. "All right, we shall show you our magic," the wizard and the goblin said. The goblin made a bag with endless treasure, and the wizard made a magic stick to fulfill wishes. The man immediately picked up the stick and made the goblin and the wizard disappear. They vanished. By the time they returned with the help of their magic, the man had disappeared with the bag and the stick. The wizard and goblin cried over their foolishness. The poor man lived a wonderful and happy life thanks to their gifts. A Christmas gift. One Christmas day, a couple found a sweet little girl in a basket with a note. "Keep me warm and fed always. I will bring you good luck, Shirley." The lady took little Shirley into the house and their luck changed for good. Many years passed and Shirley grew up into a beautiful young girl. One rainy day, Shirley fell sick. The couple took good care of her, but she grew more ill. Their luck changed for the worse. the man said to his wife, "Get some food from the neighbors. The roof rafters can be burnt to keep Shirley warm till you return." He was about to pull the roof down when Shirley said, "I am actually a fairy. And this was just a test. I now know how much you love me. I will stay with you always," Shirley said, hugging them. This time, their luck stayed forever. The Goblin and the Fairy. Once upon a time, there lived a cruel goblin. He turned people into rats and fed them to his pet snake. The villagers were scared of him and went to the fairy for help. She turned herself into a young girl and went to the goblin's house. The fairy said to the goblin, "Give me food and I will work for you." The goblin agreed readily. When the goblin was not at home, the fairy found a rat in a bottle. She released the rat and turned him into a boy. Then the fairy whistled and an eagle flew by. She gave him the goblin's snake to eat. When the goblin came back, the fairy muttered a spell. The goblin turned into a frog. The goblin pleaded and promised never to be wicked again. The fairy turned him back into the goblin. The villagers lived happily ever after. The dragon who caught a cold. Once, a friendly dragon named Yowler made his home in a huge cave in a mountain near the village. The rainy weather gave him a bad cold. Yowler did not recover for many months. Yowler sneezed a lot. Each time he sneezed, fire and smoke came out of his nostrils. The villagers were scared, but none had the courage to go up the mountain to see who was there. Finally, a little brave boy agreed to go. He wanted only a large bag of sweets to eat along the way. As the boy neared the cave, he heard someone weeping and sneezing. He entered the cave and saw a huge dragon who cried, "I'm Yowler. I have a bad cold." Feeling sorry, the boy gave him a few sweets. Yowler's cold vanished after eating the sweets. After this, Yowler and the brave boy became good friends. Son for the Prince's Crown. Once upon a time, a king and a queen had a child whom they loved dearly. One morning, the little prince saw the sun shining brightly in the sky. "I want the sun for my crown," he demanded. The king asked the court magician to get the sun for the prince. The magician lit a candle, put it on the windowsill of the prince's room and called out, "If the sun wishes to stay on the little prince's crown, you are welcome." The curious sun heard the magician. He came swooping down at night and saw the crown on the bedside table. The sun placed itself on the crown. The next morning, the prince was happy to see the sun on his crown. As he picked it up, he burnt his hand. "My hand hurts. Take the sun away," he cried. The sun rose up in the sky with a smile. The little prince learnt his lesson and lived happily ever after. Fairyland. One fine day, two sisters, Alice and Elliot, ran off to play without telling their mother. They sat under a tree to rest and realized that they were lost. Something landed on Alice's shoulder. It was a tiny fairy. "You didn't tell your mother you were going to play?" she asked gently.
"No, and we are lost," cried Alice.
"Do not cry. Look around you," the fairy said, smiling. Alice and Elliot wiped their tears and saw that they were in Fairyland. Tiny flowers fluttered, elves ran around, and tiny trees sang as they swayed into the cool breeze. Alice and Elliot had the most wonderful time of their lives. "Now, the rabbits will guide you to your home," said the fairy. Two rabbits showed Alice and Elliot the road towards their home. The sisters apologized to their worried mother. The next time Alice and Elliot went to meet the fairy, they took their mother along too. The rich man's son. Once there lived a rich man in a village. One day, the rich man took away a poor farmer's land and said, "If your daughter marries my son, you can have your land back." The lovely daughter was upset but ready to get married, even though she knew that the son of the rich man was half goat and half man. So the marriage took place. At first, the daughter was scared of the rich man's son. However, she soon found that he was a kind and gentle man. After a year, the couple had a baby boy. As soon as the rich man's son touched his child, he became fully human. Then, the rich man's son told her that an evil witch had cursed him. Only the true love of a lady and the birth of his first child would free him. He thanked his wife and presented her with many jewels. The Forest Fairy. One day, a shepherd decided to take his son out to the pasture. His wife packed them the lunch and said, "Do not be late for supper. The forest is not safe at night. If you are scared, call the forest fairy." The shepherd and his son enjoyed themselves in the pasture and lost track of time. They started walking back home at dusk. The forest was full of strange sounds. The boy remembered his mother had talked of a forest fairy. He chanted, "Forest fairy, please guide us." Soon, they found a shining ball on the way. Lo, it turned into the forest fairy and led them home. She asked them to be careful next time. Then, she flickered and vanished. When they reached home, the wife said, "I prayed to the forest fairy." "So did I," said the son. They ate their supper and slept peacefully, thanking the forest fairy for her kindness.